Welcome back to another vlog. Today's video is going to be a grocery haul vlog, but I'm doing a pickup order. It's been a while. So I think the last one I done was back in January when we got sick. So I'm doing a grocery pickup from Walmart today, but I think I'm gonna run in Kroger for some of the produce because I just don't trust Walmart to pick my produce because theirs isn't that great anyway. So we're on our way out now, and I guess I might vlog a little bit while we're out. So I decided, since it's early and there's not a lot of people here, because I'm not a, like, I'm a people person, but I'm not a people-y person. So I'm more of an introvert. So when I go in a store and there's a lot of people, I feel like I'm done. I don't even want to be there. But I thought, since I'm doing a grocery order, I ended up getting a slot for later this evening. So we'll go pick that up later. But I've got to run in Kroger and get the produce items. But TJ Maxx is not that crowded. So I'm going to go in here because I need an oven mitt and like pot holder thing. And then there was like three other things that I wanted to look at. She never starts talking until I pick up the camera. But I also never got that salad or the produce container in here. So I have like three things that I wanted to look at. So I figured I would just take the opportunity to glance around before I go get our produce, because of course I'll have to go home after that. So I guess this is going to be a TJ Maxx shop with me / Walmart grocery haul. And I used my last rewards for a pumpkin spice latte. It was necessary. So I wasn't really necessarily looking for anything specific other than three items that I've been looking around for and couldn't find, but I noticed they had a ton of fall stuff out this time. I was, of course, immediately drawn to the blankets and throw pillows and things, and I was so very tempted to buy one of these throw blankets. I would really like to have a fall print one, and I almost did, but I was like, no. That could just be grocery money. I don't actually need it. I think I like the leaf print one the most, and I actually really like just the basic colored ones. And I did almost buy these also, because I still haven't made my mind up on a salt and pepper shaker for the table, and they were only $3.99. And I also saw some huge trays, so if you need a tray for like a coffee table or dining area, definitely check out TJ Maxx. These were humongous. They had seasonal ones and regular ones. It is Winnie the Pooh, that's right.
It's Seacombe.
I noticed that they actually had a few of the Ray Dunn mugs that had the toppers on them, and they also had some really cute just basic fall mugs. I know for years past that these always went super fast because they were very trendy. I think the Ray Dunn stuff has died down a little bit, but I'm more drawn to the mugs like this, where it's just kind of like typical fall, and I thought this was so cute, and Willow was so excited. She kept pointing and saying, it's a poo, it's a poo, and now I'm kind of regretting not buying this. I only have 2 fall mugs, but I had a big one and a little one, and then this one I saw, and it instantly reminded me of my sister, the color and the print, so I got her a little surprise. And these were the containers I was looking at last time I was here. I actually think I want to go back and get one of these double ones because I think it will work out perfect for berries since usually I buy Willow 2 kinds of berries each week. And they had some really cute pumpkin-shaped cookware and storage canisters I thought was very cute, as well as some seasonal, just really random type of food items. I've tried a few food items from here before. They're always very fresh and very good. And I noticed the pasta, was drawn to the colors, but ended up deciding on getting one of these. I think I'm going to share a meal sometime here shortly within the next few weeks using it because it just looks so festive. And I mean, you know, it's $4 a box. It's dinner. It's not a big deal. They had several little treats and like caramel and popcorn and things like that. They had this cinnamon bun popcorn. Popcorn's one of my weaknesses, so I was proud of myself for not buying any of this, but let me just say I could have. They also had some really cute oven mitts and aprons. I actually went in here looking for an oven mitt, and they only had like the hand ones that just go over your fingers, and they were kind of expensive, so I didn't end up getting one. I did see several hand towels that were super cute. There was 2 of them in particular, or 3. This little white one right here I love that I almost got, but I don't need any, so I didn't get any. They also had like the disposable dinnerware and coffee cups and treat containers and some little Thanksgiving style plates. And they had a lot of storage stuff in here too. So this was new items that I did not see the last time I was in here. So definitely check out TJ Maxx for any kind of storage containers, whether it's for your home or your refrigerator or whatever. Ours was just packed. And of course I noticed the little pumpkin topped pan.
Thank you.
update my wardrobe. I know everybody always talks about like their winter wardrobe, their summer, their spring, whatever. I'm not that person. I'd have pretty much the same clothing that I've had for years, and I just add to it or try to change it up, or occasionally I'll find something on sale and I'll grab it. But I decided that I want to start trying to buy me at least a few shirts, especially for like the upcoming cooler months. And I saw several of these on the rack, and I kept telling myself that they were not going to fit, that I was still too big to fit them. And I was actually very surprised. Every single one fit very well, except for that last kind of white striped one. But I ended up just going with this one. I thought it looked good for fall. I want to go back, though, and get the little hoodie shirt. And then I was glancing at the coat section and the sweaters, and these two were my favorite. I actually think I love this one the most. Wasn't my size, but it was $40, and I'm just going to say, if it was my size, I would have been so, so tempted to get it, because, I don't know, I just love that kind of Western-looking stuff, and I always get sucked in at checkout at TJ Maxx. I feel like everyone does. They have all the good mugs and candles and children's books and things up here, and so I had to look through all of the fall ones, of course, and on the candles, I noticed this time that they had a lot that were just really cute, specifically for decorating purposes, not so much burning. Normally I feel like they have more basic looking ones, but there were some really cute ones in here that would look good in like tiered trays or on coffee tables and such. I also love to look through the children's books up here. I was looking for like some fall or Thanksgiving ones, but they really only had Halloween, so didn't really find anything here. Make it a point to walk through the seasonal like decorative section in our local Kroger anytime I come in here and have a little bit of time. I have found so many random little goodies over here. I don't know why they have such a good selection in like home decor and just little random things for your house here, but they do, and I actually really love a lot of it. I feel like a lot of it is very up to date, very up with the trends, whatever you want to say. I'm always drawn to the coffee mugs and things like that they have, but I was still looking for an oven mitt. I had not found one yet. At TJ Maxx, they had one that I liked, but it was like $10. Wasn't full size, but they did have some really cute signs here. I love some of the ones that said like pumpkin patch and things, but I have so many decor pieces with words on it, and I didn't need to buy anymore, so I was just trying to let y'all kind of get a peek of what we had in here right now. I thought these little mugs were so cute. They were very small, and they also had some really cute like harvest fall themed dishes in their kitchen section of the store. I thought these were really pretty and could honestly be used year round too if you were looking for a good dish set. I was also so excited. I found a bottle of Sriracha. This is the Kroger brand. Home now, and it seems so weird because I have been so used to actually coming up on a year. So the year of the pandemic, I was pregnant and then had Willow, and the following year we done grocery pickups specifically, and then we done a few home deliveries, but the pickup just worked better. So at the end of last year I started going in store to get our groceries and get Willow's WIC items and stuff. So it's been right at a year that I've been going in, so it seems so weird to be home and not unloading groceries up in the day. I did get an evening slot for a pickup, so we'll have that tonight, but I was thinking tomorrow is when we would get it. I don't know. Just seems so strange. So this is my little mini haul that I got going in store. So at Kroger, I got Willow's blueberries, some cucumbers, and on the way to the register, I saw these walnuts were like half off, and there are several little recipes, especially like fall specific recipes that call for walnuts, and I have a few like on Pinterest and things that I want to try, so I got those. I'm sure if you eat sriracha, you've heard there is a shortage, but I saw that it's because like something to do with the chili pepper that goes in here. Got Willow a store snack, some bananas. I got a lot because I need to freeze some. I lost my freezer stash because the freezer thawed out. This is for my sister. I picked her out a little fall mug. I thought she needed one. And it reminded me of her, and the handle color reminded me of her, but it's so cute. It has a little pumpkin and a pie, acorn, flower, leaves, and apple. It says happy fall, y'all. I got this little, I think some people call these Silpat gnats. I'll just go ahead and open it. But I thought this was so cute. It's for a like a cookie sheet when you're baking. You don't have to use any kind of oil. It just makes it nonstick. And I have a red one that's technically like a Christmas one. I got more down years ago. But I thought this would be cute since I'm planning on sharing like some recipes that would call for something like that. I got this little book for my niece. She's obsessed with dinosaurs. My nephew and Willow have a little combined get together Sunday for their birthdays, and I got her a small little present, and this was only $2.99, so I got that to go in her little gift bag. And then I got these socks. So this is a joint thing, so I really wanted the pumpkin pear, and my sister is always cold and loves all the cozy warm things, so I'm gonna give her, I thought this pair looked like her, and I might go ahead and give her this pair. I really just wanted the pumpkin ones, so she's got a little fall gift. And then I saw this. It was $4.79, which is a little bit more than regular pasta, but I was like, you know, it's not every day that you see leaf shaped pasta, and this was just so cool. So I might make like a little fall pasta dish or something one day and share. I'll share when I make it either way. And then this was the shirt that I decided on. It was $19.99. I never spend money on myself, especially not full price, but I was pretty excited. This is a 2X, and this fit, and then there were actually some 1X shirts that fit really good. I showed y'all the ones I tried on, and I really wanted like the orange hoodie shirt thingy, but I decided to get this one because it's a little more dressy, so I could dress it up or down and it looks like fall. And then I thought if I were to go back to buy that one would be more likely to be there, and also it's kind of like a little generic look, so I could probably still and yet find one of those at some point. So I would like to get it, but I'm just gonna go ahead and say I probably won't go back. And then I'm so excited, I found the pumpkin spice Belvita biscuits. I used to eat these all the time for breakfast. I like the cranberry orange, the gingerbread, and the pumpkin spice. I actually think the pumpkin spice is the best one. Y'all have probably realized by now that I'm obsessed with pumpkin, and I don't even care. I have no shame. Usually I will buy like 2 or 3 boxes of those so that I have them past, because they're limited edition, that way I have them for breakfast past the time that they're released. So it's 1:45, and I'm actually about to go edit today's vlog, which is supposed to go up at 5, and I like to have them edited and premiering from the day before, that way like people can see ahead of time. But this week we've been behind because of Willow's birthday. It's no big deal. And then this evening after the grocery haul on the end of this vlog, I'll have to edit it and get it ready to go up Sunday. And then I can't remember what Wednesday's vlog is. Oh, it's a collab. It's a day in the life vlog. So I'll share that on Wednesday and share some more information on that. And then this coming week, past that point, the vlogs are really just going to take a full turn for fall. I've got to decorate the living room. I'm doing the living room next. Like this coming week.
We're headed to go get the Walmart pickup. I was thinking Michael would grab it on his way home, but timing didn't work out, and I don't want it to be too late, so we're headed to go get it now. So I'm hoping this is timed perfect enough that he'll be home and he can unload it when we get there, and then I won't have to get it all out. Okay, y'all, I am shocked. I am shocked. It is 5:20 on Friday afternoon. I can't even see. And there was only 3 cars when I pulled up here, and 2 were the pharmacy. So right now it's me and 1 other car Friday for grocery pickup, which is shocking because it's normally packed. I like to actually do these earlier in the day. I don't know. Totally random, but it's been a while since I've actually like vlogged in the car other than like 5 or 6 seconds. If you use like a tripod, like one of the little dash mount things for your phone, I have a, like a Galaxy S20. Let me know which one you use, because I bought one from Ross and it was a waste of money. It would not even stick to the dash. Doesn't work at all. And I have one of the little handheld ones with like the bendable legs that my sister gave me, but I want one that like mounts on my dash. And I don't know what to buy. I'm tired of like buying things that don't work. So if you use one of those for work, for YouTube, whatever, specifically for a smartphone, and I do have a bigger one, comment below with a link or just tell me where you got yours.
So this is our weekly Walmart grocery haul. I done a pickup earlier. It's a little bit less than normal because I got some of the produce. Those were 2 of the things I got. But I got some of the produce items from Kroger earlier instead of doing it on this. So I got 1 pound of ground turkey. I cannot even remember what I wanted this for, but it was on my list. And I had the natural casing smoked sausage. We honestly think that one tastes a lot better. And in the past, we didn't like this, but this was a substitution, so I'm just going to try it. Needed some bell peppers, and I needed like quick stuff because I'm going to do a probably crock pot meal this coming Wednesday for like a fall day in the life / cook with me vlog. And I think I'm going to use that. Depends on what I make. Haven't made my mind up yet. Head of broccoli. Can't remember what this is for either. I'll have to figure it out. 2 oranges. Can't remember what this is for. I saw the pumpkins popped up, so I'm going to decorate with these. So I got they're called Tiger Stripe, and then a pack of these little mini ones. And I'll probably end up buying like 1 more bag of like the mixed ones. Another thing of the baby arugula and spinach mix. Gallon of milk. Michael needed oil for his truck, so I got 2 of those. Some body wash for him instead of using like the non-scented Hunting body wash. I told him he should try this, and then his skin wouldn't dry out so bad, so this one's like non-scented. Supposed to be better for your skin. And then some chicken patties for like a quick meal or sandwich or something. I got a good bit of the Progresso soup compared to how many I usually get. I'm hooked on this one. I'm actually going to eat this for dinner tonight. This isn't one of the light ones, but I've said before, if you check the cans, they're usually all well under 500 calories, which is excellent. So that's my favorite right now. And then I got these 3. I love these for like when I'm close to going over and need something lighter. So I got 3 of those. I got a green tea. I did have, I think it was like mango mandarin or something, or peach mango, and they were out. That was a substitution. This is for a recipe. I haven't decided which one. I needed some half calf. I like this. It actually tastes good. And when I drink coffee in the afternoon, that's what I drink. If you haven't tried the Dream World, it tastes like a citrusy Coke. We liked it, and we get the 0. So I got one of those instead of Diet Coke this week. This was a substitution I had gotten. I think it was like the Great Value or something, and that's what they substitute with. I want to say this is also for a recipe, but I can't remember what. I'm making Willow a cookie cake for when we do their little birthday, my nephew and hers birthday on Sunday. So I got her this kind because, of course, y'all know she loves these. Only thing is, I was going to get a container of like that spray icing, and I didn't, so I'll have to figure something out myself. Another jar of garlic. I go through this a lot, especially with like crock pot meals and soups. And I only think I have like 1 on my stocked shelf right now. I had Great Value ginger. They were out, so I substituted that one. 2 cans of pears because Willow has eaten a few cans this week. And I had the 100% juice, but they were out, so they substituted me the Splenda ones. So I think we still have some 100% juice ones. I'll give her those first, and this is a last resort. 2 cans of beef broth, 2 cans of chicken. I try to add like 4 cans of any random vegetable or broth per order to keep a stock up. I needed some super glue. Actually, the main thing is I have these little corner guards. There's one right here. So I have these little corner guards because this counter is sharp and I have bruised my hip, and I don't want Willow hitting her head and they just lose their stick. So I was thinking maybe super glue would work, but now I'm wondering if I really should have just got like Gorilla Glue or something. We were running out of American cheese. I got one pie pumpkin. I have one or two things I want to do with a fresh pumpkin, but I also would like to decorate with one. But since they cut the stem so short on this one, I'm probably going to cook with it. And I was thinking it'd be fun to let Willow paint one at some point. One can of pumpkin to replace one that I've already used. Some cans of pineapple juice. I like to drink pineapple juice several times a week. Michael goes through a ton of sugar with his tea and coffee, so I got another bag to replace what he's used. He's eating these mostly now instead of the Nutty Bars or Nutty Buddy. I can never remember what they're called. Two packs of the diaper, training pant, pull-ups, whatever. And this was on Ibotta this week for free, so I got this one to try out. It's got like 3,000 micrograms of collagen. I thought the flavor was interesting, so we will see. And that is all. This was a really quick haul this week. So thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, comment down below. Stay tuned for, goes up Sunday, for Wednesday. It's going to be another collaboration, day in the life with like fall stuff. And I'm going to share a recipe. I haven't figured out. I may share one or two because I had a few ideas, but I don't know what.